Everybody, it's Lynn from WisconsinGarden.com. Welcome back for part two of our mid-May garden tour. We took you on a tour of the outer berm on the east side of our property, and we are now going to take you on the inner side of the berm and show you what's blooming there. Enjoy. As some of you may know, we've been trying to plant more native plants, native to the state of Wisconsin, that take probably no time at all because they take care of themselves. All you have to do is trim them back. So in here will be a whole bunch of Western sunflowers. Now the flower itself will be small, it'll be yellow, but it'll be prolific. I usually have to put a little fence up here, but they're coming up nicely. And then this is the compass plant that we've all talked about so often. This one will also get at least 6 feet tall, and then its stalk, its flower stalk, will get at least 10 feet tall. It has very sandpapery leaves, as you may remember, and it tries to orient its leaves north and south, which is why the pioneers used it to determine the compass and how they were going. And then there's wisteria. Wisteria is a very happy vine. When it blooms, it has purple hanging purple flowers that are absolutely gorgeous.
I'm trying to think of the flower that grows upwards. It's a bulb, not hydrangea, hyacinth. This is like an upside down hyacinth. Mm-hmm. I mean, it was spectacular last year, and we had so many seeds. I'm wondering, do we do anything with those seeds?
No, we haven't. And I'm sure they're going to be coming up someplace along the way as well, because they're very viable when they're in the ground.
And now that we're on the inside,
now you can see where we still have a lot of work to do.
Oh, that grass in here. This area we talked about.
Right.
Everything is coming out of here. And we're starting over.
Or you're going to take the lawnmower.
No, no. We're just going to go in section by section.
Now we have a lot of flax in here, but you can see the grass has taken over. There's hostas that are trying to come up.
Well, you try that grass be gone, right?
I haven't tried it on here. Well, last year I tried it a little bit. Sort of worked. Obviously didn't work for very long. This is a grass that is just horrible, probably native. It has long roots, and there's
those yellow
band.
And
yeah, there's a band of yellowish white, and then there's a darker band, and then the band, and it sends out roots everywhere. So you can never just dig it out because it doesn't work.
Yeah, you got several different kinds of hostas in there, and
yes,
I see some sedum back there.
Usually the deer eat this. This is phlox. Yeah. Phlox also spreads itself around.
Now, one thing we found about hosta and deer, they like smooth leaf.
Yes, that's why they like this kind of hosta. And you can see this one might have been nibbled on at the very beginning.
In there too.
So the sweeter and the more tender the leaf, the more the deer like it.
But if you have a wrinkled leaf like this one, they didn't seem to bother at all.
No, that's the same variety. I think it should end farther. We'll show you a wrinkly one. Then you have these. This is the state flower. This is a wood violet. And while beautiful as they can be, they are very invasive.
Well, we didn't plant
They're
it
everywhere.
There.
We did not plant any of it. It just showed up. Huh. It's native.
And then you have a...
That's a lilac.
Lilac, right.
That we always keep trimmed down because we don't want to block. We don't want it to take over. So we never get any blossoms on it because we keep trimming it back.
I think we are going to let it take over.
Well, no, are we? News to me. Then we have another tree peony, started from seed.
Well, we put, I think, three of them in this area. There's another one
this
over
one,
there.
This one I stepped on when we were cleaning out.
Yes.
I stepped on it, and I thought, oh, you poor thing. So I put it back up, and I tied it up to a little stick And lo and behold, it made it anyway.
So I didn't have to call the plant abuse police?
No, thank goodness. Then we have the Virginia bluebells. Now you think, oh my gosh, they've taken over. And yes, they have.
I'd rather have that than weeds.
Yes. But within a month, they'll be gone. You'll never know they were even here. They just disappear.
They decompose.
And they're very hard to share. I tried to share some with our daughter at least twice. And they don't like to be moved. I don't know. I think we bought the first one.
So didn't Lark give us some?
Or maybe Lark did. Thank you, Lark. Yes, I think you're right. And I don't know.
There's another tree peony.
Yes.
Has a nice blossom on it.
Mm-hmm.
And I think that's another one back there, if I remember correctly.
I think that's Bleeding Heart.
Oh.
Bleeding Heart also spreads everywhere. Now, you see the tall things there with the little purple?
The onions?
Those are the...
Allium?
Alliums, yes. It's the allium family, and I believe those are the ones that get the big purple head on them. I've planted them everywhere, so if I haven't planted them, somehow they got moved. So the seeds come out really easily, and if you move them, you plant them yourself.
Well, remember the roses we grew from seed?
Yes. Oh, those roses.
They were, especially over here, these were magnificent. They were apricot color.
Yep.
And they bloomed for a long time.
They did. And their thorns, talk about quince thorns.
Those are wicked.
The quince thorns are big. These are little and they're just terrible.
They went through my leather gloves.
Yes, yes. But they're so beautiful that if you get the right equipment and you can trim them and keep them from taking over, they're worth it.
Yeah.
But the tulips came very late this year, but they're beautiful and we're enjoying them.
It was so cold and gloomy. I mean, we had over 40 days of cloudy, cold, wet, damp.
Yes.
I can't even call it spring.
And now
it was a horrible spring.
Now we're in August.
I'm sweating and this is early morning.
This is our purple leaf smoke tree. Started off as a tree, then it was a bush, now it's a tree again. So,
I mean, we had to trim off so many dead areas. It's kind of a strange-looking
sculpture. Yes, it is. But
sculpture.
It'll be pretty.
The Bosnian Pine?
Bosnian Pine, doing well. Interesting shape.
I still like that ground cover.
I know. It gets everywhere.
I know
everywhere.
You don't like it, but I do.
Well, it's better than thistles and grass.
And are these wild strawberries that are in there, or are those?
Those are those decorative strawberries that you at one time planted.
Because I'm thinking of moving all of our strawberries.
Yeah, I've kind of given up on strawberries. This is a honeysuckle that...
Trying to escape.
It tied itself up here. I did not tie it. It tied itself up. See? You should be going this way. I'll be back.
Okay, Arnie.
This is monk's hood. This, you sometimes read about it in murder mysteries because people have used it in a naughty way.
Naughty.
Some people are very allergic to it, even just to touch the leaves. I don't have that problem. But it develops beautiful flowers and they're kind of poisonous. So,
and look
careful.
Look what's
This is anemone. Again, this is one of the things, it shows up in the spring, it flourishes, and then it disappears. So it's somewhere in here, there used to be, and I think it's right there, Japanese iris, which are more grass-like. And then there is our tricolor beech, which at the end of the year we're thinking, oh, I hope it makes it. And look at it. It's flourishing.
It has such great leaves early. I mean, the tree looks like it's on fire.
Yes.
I mean, when we're sitting in the front porch and the sun, it's amazing.
Yes. We've learned now, keep it moist. It likes to have moist ground rot. Not soggy, but it likes water.
I like water.
Yes, you do.
But I'm not soggy. And then you have to look at this. I mean,
this is another crabapple tree, and do we even know what kind it is? Yes, this is Profusion. We've had this one for many years, and Rick has kept it into a lollipop shape, which I love. And look at the colors. Just magnificent. And people say, well, yeah, if you have a crab apple, though, it's going to drop all those little crab apples. Yes, it does. They don't seem to start new plants, and the animals and the birds like them. And they're not in our way. This is a Weigela plant, or Weigela, however you pronounce it. This is a reblooming one. So once it blooms in the spring, trim back the part that bloomed, and it'll bloom again before fall.
And then you also have a
mock orange.
Mock orange back there.
Yep, there's a mock orange here. The smell of that is absolutely wonderful.
Yep.
And then, is that also a mock orange?
That's a Weigela back there. I don't know where we put that other mock orange.
I think it is this it?
Yes, it is.
Yes.
That's it.
Yeah. So they're wonderful.
And
they're
don't you
wonderful.
Have another ginkgo tree growing?
I do. It's
no,
that's not it.
No. There it is.
Oh yeah, inside that little cage right next to the pink tulip.
Purple.
Which is or purple. And it too is budding out. Yeah. So that one made it.
And all your sweet William just seems to keep going on and on and on, even in wintertime. Not so much the blossoms, but
right.
That
oh,
greenery.
They're tough. Yeah, they're
all
tough.
Right,
and these are wild.
Coral bells?
No, these are. That's coral bell right there, okay. the purpley.
We had a marker orange. For these. Where did they all disappear?
I don't know.
The squirrels took them?
I think they do move them around just to be cantankerous. And then you'll see that these are our Alberta spruce, dwarf Alberta spruce, that looked terrible this spring because they were burned by the winds and the cold and then sunshine on them.
And we don't cover them with burlap.
No.
So.
And you can see they've recovered.
Yeah.
They'll recover.
And I'd say
themselves.
Since the two large maple trees are gone, the birch is doing really well so far this spring.
It's going to be very happy. You can see it was leaning this way because the trees were behind it blocking the sun.
Yeah.
So it's very feathery looking. I like it.
And more Virginia, is that?
No, that's
lungwort.
Right.
Yeah.
This is lungwort, perfect lungwort time. It comes up, the blossoms are blue, and they turn pink. And then, or it comes up pink, I forget now, if it comes up
pink.
Blue or if it comes up pink. Hmm. I think it comes up pink and then it turns blue. And these will, if you move them, they will just keep on growing and be very happy in your yard.
And then back there, is that more
that is
yellow?
Forsythia.
Forsythia. That didn't
right.
bloom this year, though.
I trimmed that way, way back because
okay.
it was almost as tall as that lilac bush.
And that's a Miss Kim?
We're not sure. But this is Logan's birch. He named this birch. Logan Marcus Rico.
One of his names for each branch, right?
Yes, right.
Very clever.
Yes, he is a clever boy. This is a ground cover I don't like.
Oh, but I like it.
No.
It's much better than grass.
Yeah,
Lenny, I would take this over grass any day. Any day.
And now all the yellow you see, that is wood poppy, woodland poppy. They too can take over if you don't get the seed pods. If you don't care if they take over, just leave them and they'll just take over. But
now this side of this...
This is a sandhill...
Yes.
Yes, that's what it is.
But that side there does not look good at all. I think we have to do some serious trimming on that.
We may have to do some trimming, but look, it's budding from the bottom. I mean, the leaves are coming out. So
the bottom,
just,
right.
Yeah, maybe it's just lowing.
Or it hasn't started, I don't know.
Yeah, well, it's maybe just starting. And again, the tulips, These are later tulips.
And that peony that we transplanted the day they cut down the...
The snake willow.
The snake willow.
When it was 90 and I almost had heat prostration again. That one is the red one, according to our marker. And next to it, under that other cage, which you can't see now, which we totally thought was gone, is a pink one. And we bought those at the farmer's market, and they had the most beautiful blossoms on them. We were sick when they didn't do well.
Yeah.
But, you know, you give them a chance. You never know. Then this is our flowering cherry.
Which just ended.
Yes, you can see it was pink. It was very lovely.
This had been blossoming for at least 3 weeks, I would say.
Mm-hmm.
It was magnificent.
Actually,
and look at your honeysuckle.
Then honeysuckle.
Oh my goodness.
Going to town here.
You may have to...
Yes.
...cut it back to walk through this archway.
Well, I have cut it back many a time, but you can see how thick it's getting now.
Yeah?
It's really wood right now.
Well, good, because when this metal cage rots...
It can hold up the cage.
Yes. And here's... I'm so glad to at least see something coming back from this, because...
Yes, we thought this one was gone. We didn't think it was going to make it at all. This is our Daphne, and it's supposed to be a semi-evergreen, and usually it would stay green for most of the winter. This year, it all went this way. But look at it now.
And then here's your other quince.
Yes, this is a quince. This one has never actually produced any fruit, but it also does not have any spikes on it.
Yeah, this is, I love the colors.
Yes, bright, bright.
And?
Oh, we mangled on this one. It's a grafted tree, so the bottom part is the same as the flowering cherry next to it. It's got the same trunk. With the
you can see where it was grafted.
Yes. And for whatever reason, instead of weeping like it was supposed to be weeping, the stalks, the branches kept going up straight in the air. And try as we might, several times we even tied it down. Yeah, it just wasn't weeping. Maybe it was too happy and it didn't want to weep. But anyway, we cut it way back, early spring. And it's flowering.
Well, now in these containers yesterday, you planted...
In this container, I planted seeds because Rick didn't want anything that was going to obstruct the pathway. So there are coxcomb from Scott, and these are supposed to be giant pansies. Well, I planted the pansies in the house and they never sprouted. Coxcomb is coming up, but very slowly. So I thought, well, I'll put them outside. That's where they were supposed to be in the first place. Then I went through all of our dahlias. And this year, we had the best luck with dahlias. So I've got one dahlia in the middle. And then these little plants here were zinnias from last year because I had zinnias in here. So I carefully took those out, planted them, and then I also planted some more zinnia seeds in here. In here, more dahlias. And this is what we got this year. We never before have had luck with our dahlias.
Well, we kept them in peat moss.
We kept them in peat moss.
In a box.
And I sprayed them once or twice a month throughout the winter.
And you covered them with burlap
Covered them with actual
with cardboard.
Paper.
Yeah,
and just let them be. And lo and behold, they started blossoming. In here are Peruvian daffodils.
And those are great.
These are coming up. There were some baby bulbs, bulblets, I guess you'd call them. So I planted those separately. Actually, I'm giving these one to my sister and a couple to somebody else. Over here, next to the driveway, variety of tulips, which I love. These are going to be different... I forgot the name of them. Phlox, variegated phlox. This is another giant fleece plant, which I'm taking out.
Look at that. The runner is way over there next to the hosta.
I know.
This has to come out.
And, well, look at the ferns, too. They're coming right up inside the bush. So this is coming out because it just takes over. These, I'm really not pleased with these because they do spread everywhere. Bugbane gets tall. There's dahlias in here and a canna. Decided to put a canna there.
Lots of daisies.
So in here we have another dahlia. And this one I haven't planted anything yet. Probably seeds.
Now this is that Mexican...
This is a Mexican sunflower. This one too.
Oh no, this is a helenium.
Oh, that's right. This is a helenium.
To be massive.
This will get big. It will look like a bush.
Yeah.
And that's fine. And Astilbe are in each of these railroad things. Now yesterday, this is what one of Rick's many projects yesterday was. He bought these for me. These are
fiber optics.
They're fiber optics. They're solar, and at nighttime they turn on and they change colors. And he said, I want to put them in the fence so that they'll just be lovely. And then he put up new post lights. We've had the old post lights forever and they just didn't do well. You may be hearing that house wren who is scolding us for being there. She is. I believe she's in the blue house.
Rent free.
Somebody else might be in the top. The flower in the basket is from our daughter for Mother's Day. And these are, again, tree peonies that some of them we purchased and some of them were from our own.
Well, this is an Itoh.
Yes.
Which is magnificent.
That one is.
Or
yes.
The one that's coming up.
The one
there.
That's covered, yes, or in the cage.
Somebody has
today is cottonwood. Cottonwood time. Whew. But look at this.
Remember, we had this beautiful Japanese red maple here, and it totally died on us.
Yes. And we think it was because of the compacting of soil when we had the house.
Resided, yeah.
And so we cut off the parts that obviously weren't coming back, and we thought, we'll just leave it. Last year, there was a glimpse of branches coming out of it, and look at it now. It's more of a bush tree.
This grew like this in just a little over 1 week.
Yes.
Because there was nothing but
twigs.
Like you said, twigs.
There were twigs there, yep.
Well, the birds like it. I can't tell you how many times I fill up the bird feeder, and now we have the finch feeder up.
Yes.
So.
And we have an oriole, a Baltimore oriole.
Oh, and you saw
feeder.
A blue indigo bunting
indigo
as well.
Indigo bunting was down here, and we saw an oriole yesterday or the day before. It was magnificent. We hope you enjoyed the ending of part two, and we would love to hear from you. We'd love your comments and questions. Also, if you'll give us a thumbs up, that would be very much appreciated. If you want to look at any more videos, got lots to choose from, go to wisconsingarden.com. And if you'd like to become part of our garden family, we invite you to subscribe. Many of you have. Thank you so much for subscribing. And if you would like to be notified when a new video comes out, there's that little bell up there. Just tap on that and it will notify you every time we get a new video up. Bye for now. Come back for part three and see you soon.
Connect with us on YouTube.